We have made the stupidest mistake ever. Guess we have forgotten to bring water for a 10 kilometer hike. So we're in Nuwara Elliya and this is the hostel we're staying at. Finally left the beach area and after 3 buses I've made it to hill country, this beautiful place called Nuwara Elliya. Well, I've ruined my day today. It's already 3:30 and I haven't stepped out of the hostel. I think it happens a lot in long-term travel. Some days you're just tired or not in the mood or seeing some new place, or you just have a conversation with someone but you end up feeling bad about it because your visa is only for 30 days and still you have to go and see places. There's so much to see. I hate this visa rules, you know. So 17 days of my trip are already over. Only 13 days are remaining. That's like almost 60% of my trip is over. So I'm in that middle phase of my trip where the country, being in a new country, seems less exciting and the pace goes down. What are the things that you really, really need to cover and plan your days accordingly? I want to tell my viewers that this guy is giving me a lift now. He offered me a lift. Thank you very much. He's from Ukraine. And you're biking all across Sri Lanka?
Yeah.
Oh, that's incredible, excellent.
Yeah.
Thank you very much.
Let's go.
Let's go. So just when you're feeling low and struggling, help arrives. I'm on my way to the town, which would have taken me at least 25-30 minutes to walk. Good morning and welcome back to the channel. Woke up at 5:45 this morning to go to this really special place, Horton's Plains. And guess who is joining us today? Our friend Roma from Ukraine. Hey buddy, how are you doing?
Man, it's very nice. Like, I have to get up at 6, go on the beautiful places. I like it.
Yeah, you able to wake up easily?
Yeah.
Or difficult to wake up?
Yeah. I was right on the go.
Oh yeah, sorry, I was a little late today morning. But
I was
It's okay.
We had to go, it's cool.
So we have this beautiful ride here, his white color bike. And it should take another 45 minutes to reach to the park head. At an altitude of 2000 meters, the road is getting steeper and steeper. Hey Roma, how do you think the ride is going?
It's perfect. No, it's very interesting.
Yeah?
But nothing else.
The road is good, alright?
It's like amazing. You know, it's like being there. It's like something unusual you never experienced before.
Yeah. And it's just 15 minutes away now. I had to get off the bike because the bike could not take my load on the slope going upwards. So Roma is gone and now I have to walk it. I can't even see him, man. Roma, where are you? Don't tell me you'll make me climb 6 kilometers. Hey, there you are. Let's go, let's go. So the ticket to this park cost us 3,800 Sri Lankan rupees. I'd say that's pretty steep for a entry to a national park, but this is also a pretty special place. So now we have reached the last point where cars can go, and from here, the hiking starts. Let's go! So the best time to visit the park is between 6 a.m. to 10 a.m. because they say after that it becomes really misty and you can't really see much. So we are here at 8 a.m. not too early, not too late. Over here, the vegetation is mostly small scrubs and plants and bushes. As you go higher, the vegetation goes thinner and thinner. So as you can see behind me, there's this nice stream. And when the British came here, what they did was they introduced a fish over here called the rainbow trout so that they could eat this fish. But they forgot that that fish not only is eaten but also eats, and that rainbow trout ate and completely finished the shrimps growing in the river. So basically the British, wherever they go, they like to mess things up with their own gyan. You are an export photographer?
No. I might do. Go.
24 hours ago, I didn't even know Roma. But now he has given me a ride to Horton's Park, which would otherwise cost me 1,500 Sri Lankan rupees. And we are hanging out in this beautiful park together. So there's a circular walking trail around the entire national park, which is around 10 kilometers in distance. And there are nice view spots everywhere. It's not steep or anything. It's going very gradual ascent so far. And right now around me, there's all bushes, tall bushes around. Inside these dense forests, it is pretty dark. And the plants have to compete very hard to get hold of sunlight. These plants and trees are fighting for light. One way to do this is to grow higher than the other plants to get the sunlight. But that has its own problem, that you can't get water. Another way to do this is to use other plants and grow around them. And there are a lot of plants that are doing that, like the black pepper plant, which is right behind me here. There's competition not just in schools and colleges, but even in forest. We have made the stupidest mistake ever. Can you imagine? Guess. We have forgotten to bring water for a 10 kilometer hike. Oh God, I'm thirsty and it's already only 2 kilometers done. Where are you guys from?
Western Australia.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
Western Australia. I'm from India.
Oh.
Yeah. Not I met far. Some Australian people in Marissa while whale watching.
Oh, oh yes. Was that good? Oh. You saw plenty?
And now the path is getting rough and raw and rocky, just like me. Guess what I found? Guess! A dab of water! Yeah! Fuck you. Water, I got water. Yes, yes. This is amazing, man. I never knew water tasted so yummy. And now, ladies and gentlemen, by your bano, may I present to you Dunya Khatam, Sansar Ka Ant, the Little World's End. Here it is. After walking in the jungle for 1.5 hours, dense forest, suddenly this wide open panorama breaks upon me, and I can now see in every direction, especially the one behind me, where you can look endlessly into the southeast direction of Sri Lanka. It just feels like the world has come to an end.
Thank you.
waiting for you on the top.
There's a place on the top?
Yeah, it's like 10 meters.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Did you see the horizon?
Yeah, but we can't hear.
Yeah. Little end, we only saw little of the end of the world. When the heat from the plane rises up, clouds are formed. And when it reaches cooler altitude, it condenses and clouds evaporate. So that is why in the afternoon time, when the heat increases, all the entire place over here is filled with clouds. That is why you should be coming to this place 6 o'clock. Between 6 o'clock and 9 o'clock, and we should have actually left our hostel by around 4:30 maybe, but we didn't know all that before reaching here. Right now we are in the center of Sri Lanka, and from on a clear day you can see from here to the ocean, but at the moment I can't even see like 5 meters ahead of me. Bad luck, maybe next time. And it's starting to rain now here, and it's time to race back down. Now we've reached the last attraction of Horton's Plain, and that is the Baker's Waterfall. You really can't go down to the water. This was India, a lot of people would be bathing in that water right now. On the way back, there is a bit of ascent, a little bit climbing uphill. And whenever you see the path is going upwards, your heart sinks a little bit. Apart from that one tap of water, there's no water available. And of course, no food. So if you're coming here, get your own lunch pack. Well, now the cloud cover is coming in everywhere and it started to drizzle. I think this is it for Horton's Plain. See you at another place in Sri Lanka at another time. And if you've reached this far, make sure to subscribe to my channel. Hit the bell icon. Namaste. Goodbye, I'm gonna pack up now.